Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today we're doing smooth PDO threads for the accordion or smile lines. So PDO threads, especially the smooth ones, are underutilized, but oftentimes it's what people want to learn. In America, we use many more barb compared to smooth. In Europe, it's the other way around. I'm going to show you how I treat smile lines, how many threads I use, and the pattern I do most of the time, and we'll go through the different depths and how exactly we inject them. Let's go to the video now. Okay, so we're using our smooth threads here. And remember I said they're underutilized. Last visit we did some PlasmaSculpt through here, and now I can see where the lines are decreasing greatly, but I'm gonna mix it up and do some threads since the PlasmaSculpt was about 6 to 7 weeks ago. So I line up where I'm going, bevel up, I want the bevel up with these, and I measure up to where I wanna go. Look for any vessels, I enter, I don't wanna be too deep, and notice how I'm torquing this down. I'm using the flexibility, and I'm always going to keep a certain depth all the way through. Of note here, your parotid duct comes this way. You don't want to be deeper than that. We want to stay at a safe level. And I'm going to mesh several threads through here. So we know where one was, and we just are creating a structural support. These threads will dissolve in about 4 to 6 months, and they'll leave collagen behind in a mesh-like fashion so that when she does smile, these lines won't be showing as an extreme crease as they are now, and in that sense, they're going to fade. What we talk about is decreasing lines and increasing skin texture and tone over time, and this is one of the real reasons that we look for results, not necessarily instantly, but over time, because these are going to fade. They're not going to instantly be gone. So we're meshing this way, and then these are totally smooth, and I'm going to take some twists, which are coiled style threads. So cleansing again, we put our smooths this way. Our twists, I'm going to cross them. And you know they're twists because there's a larger plug. So just the same depth with the twists that we were using for the smooths. And this is, it's subdermal. And I couldn't get the depth I wanted, so I'm gonna tension the skin to create a straight pathway for me. And I always wanna see a little bit of tracking of that thread coming through, and that assures me I'm at the right depth. Now the twists add a little bit more volume, but one of the reasons I'm using them here is because really what I want from them is, yes, a little bit of that volume, but I also want more thread, because more thread means more collagen building. So we're getting two benefits. And this time I went right in that line. Why not support that line? And you can see the depth I'm at. Push in, bury the thread, pull out. Very little bleeding or bruising. Smile for us now and relax. And you can see already there's more structure and support. Of course, a little bit of that is from swelling, but the idea is we're not adding volume. And when I talk about tools and fillers, we don't want to add a ton of volume down here because it is going to make her look unnatural. We're looking for pull this way from our PlasmaSculpt type procedures, but also then strengthening the skin without adding volume here. And that's the accordion lines or smile lines, as we call them. So that's lower face threads in the accordion lines. Join us on this YouTube channel. Let us know below what your experiences are and subscribe for further helpful tips. Keep our skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.